Morning. All right. So we are going to warm up while we tell you guys what's coming today, because this workout is literally like 50. We're already going to be cutting it close. So let's start warming it up.
Good to see you all. Thank you for joining us this morning.
We're on a time crunch. We are on a time crunch. So let's just start with some knee hugs as we talk about what is in store for our Strictly Strength class today. So T, you want to tell them a little bit about what's coming?
So today we've got 3-minute intervals focusing on one body part, one muscle. So for instance, we'll start with our biceps. With that, we're gonna go 3 minutes continuous. So we'll have a little bit of a switch. Let's go into some heel grabs. We will switch every 30 seconds. So the movement won't be continuous 3 minutes, same move, but it will be different moves for the duration of 3 minutes. And then the lovely Lauren created a little twist with our rest breaks in between. So we'll have 2 minutes of rest, but it's rest-ercise.
Oh, so there you go, rest-ercise.
With our rest-ercise breaks, we will be completing 5 man makers in between each round.
We know you guys have missed those, right?
Man makers, woman makers, people makers.
People makers.
Whatever you prefer to call them. We'll be doing 5 of those in between each round. Keep following along with Lauren on this warm-up. We got nice little kicks there. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Got 12 of you on here right now. The number's only gonna grow.
So just move with me as Trisha kind of chats through a little. And I guess she probably show a man maker.
Right.
So you know what? Let's use our man maker for our warm-up. Perfect idea, right? So in a man maker, it's man maker, woman maker, whatever you want to call it. It's basically every exercise smushed into one. So in a full man maker, we're going to take this slow for the warm up. You're going to come down to the floor. You're going to step it out into your high plank position. You're going to give me one push up. Lift one arm up in your row. Other arm up in your row. Step it in. You're going to come up into a shoulder press. So let's do that again. Down. Plank. Push up, row each arm one time, step it in, curl to a press. One more time, get that movement in your head. Now when we do this for real, you will have some weights with you as an option. All right, so little shake. Oh, we're doing really good on our warm-up.
We're doing good on time.
We're really afraid of getting cut off at our hour on this one. Okay, so to break this down, 3 minutes of one muscle, bicep, 3 minutes straight through. The rest is 2 minutes. You have to fit in 5 man makers. And the faster you get those man makers done, the more time you have to rest. Or maybe you take it slow and you have that whole 2 minutes. So it's up to you how you use that 2 minute rest. I will probably try to get my 5 done quickly so I have more time to breathe. And then we're gonna go on to a new muscle group, 3 minutes straight, 2 minute rest with the 5 man makers in there. All right,
so if you have dumbbells, grab them. If you do not have dumbbells, you can use 2 similar sized water bottles. You can use 2 soup cans, pretty much anything. You can grab wine bottles if you want to. Anything of similar size we will use for those 2 objects there. We've got about 45 seconds before we get started into it for this first round. What set of weights are we gonna use, Lauren? Biceps.
Biceps. I'm using my 5s. Because I know it's 3 minutes straight.
I'm going to go crazy.
You're going to go 12s?
I'm going to go 12s.
Wow.
I'm going to go 12s.
That makes me feel like I
should
do
grab your weight and get ready. We're going to start in about 20 seconds. Remember, this is 3 minutes of continuous work.
The whole time. Burning it out.
The whole time. We'll let you know when the 30 second switches are. We're going to start off with a bottom half curl. So for this one, you're only going to go halfway up. And then bring it all the way back down, all right?
Here we go.
3, 2, and 1. So it's halfway up, all the way down. Take things slow. You can stay in the same spot. You want a little bend in the knees here. Keep your elbows tucked close to the sides of your body. And these feel easy in the beginning. But remember, it's 3 total minutes of work. You're gonna regret these very, very soon.
Yes, you are.
I like it though. Go big. We're gonna take it into a top half. So from that halfway point all the way up,
down to halfway this time. All the way up, down to halfway. Core super tight, keep those hips tucked, elbows close. My arms haven't touched weights.
A couple weeks.
A month. We're gonna go full range, top to bottom in 3, 2, and 1. Keep them slow, all the way up and all the way down. Got 30 seconds here. Take your time with these. No swinging of the arms. You want everything slow motion. We are working at strictly strength today. Yeah.
Another tip for biceps is to not bring it all the way to your chest. You notice it almost like rests on you. So you actually stop a couple inches before you get to your shoulders.
All right, change up. Hold your left arm at 90 degrees. Ooh. Curl your right arm. Woo, this is okay. This is where I went wrong. This is the hard one.
Constant hold on that left side. Tuck that elbow in.
90 degree hold. Couple more this side before we switch. Woo. 3, 2, 1. Hold your right arm lifted if you can. And curl. We're in our final minute of this bicep series. How we feeling?
Hey, biceps.
Hey, yay.
I like that we're starting out with those smaller muscles today. Right. So you'll feel them even more when we get into those bigger muscle groups.
Last move. Release both arms, palms face in towards your body. We're gonna reverse curl. So your palms, as you lift, are gonna face away from you.
Those elbows still do stay tucked in. Palms down towards the floor. Final 15 seconds. That means
it.
That 2 minute rest-ercise is coming, which is 5 man makers. Rest and man makers just don't belong in the same sentence. 3, 2. All right, this 2 minutes is yours. So 5 man makers, however you get them done.
Remember your man maker, plank. Push up, row, row, come up to the top.
Another bicep curl, and a shoulder press.
5 total, and then you earned your rest.
You can always rest, like when you come down in that plank position, you don't have to keep your hands on the dumbbells if that makes you uncomfortable. And if you have water bottles, definitely don't keep them there. You can just put your hand down and pick up that weight as you shift. For the rest of that 2 minutes. So keep working on it, fight for that form, core tight. Yeah, nice work. Next muscle group coming your way, about 45 seconds, we are looking at the triceps. So think about
smaller muscles,
yep.
Lighter weights.
Exactly, okay. Think about, you know, you're gonna be pressing up towards gravity. So think about that when you pick your dumbbell weight, if you have options. Whew.
30 seconds. Keep shaking those arms out. Don't grab your weights just yet. Quick sip of water if you need it. Oh. Ooh, we're up to 16.
Hey, hey. All right, friends, 15 seconds. We hit 3 minutes straight of triceps. Challenge yourself here.
I did go up on weight.
You went up on weight now.
I know. I should have gone heavier.
Crazy lady. All right. Both weights go up overhead. Tuck your elbows in nice and close. We're going to do extensions here. Both weights. Keep your back nice and flat. Soft bend in your knees. Tuck your hips just slightly forward and flatten out the back. You can have your weights touching or you can keep them slightly separated. That's up to you. Get 10 more seconds of double, then we'll go to single arm. I want you to keep your right elbow bent at the bottom, left arm only. Let's go, 30 seconds here. So that right arm is holding. Try not to rest it on your head.
Yeah.
Harder than it looks, right?
Quite a bit of stabilizing.
Shoulder doing a little bit of work, triceps. I usually feel it more in the arm that's not moving than I do in the arm that's moving. 10 seconds here before we switch up that hold and single arm extension in 3, 2, 1. Opposite arm stays still. Ooh, to that arm that was holding. That's why I said to hold the right arm first. Typically, a lot of us have a stronger right arm. Don't worry, this is our last 30 seconds of overhead. We'll go into a hip hinge position up next. Finish up these last few reps here. 5, 4, 3, 2. Drop the weights to your side. Roll them up and kick back. 30 seconds, just straight kickbacks. Palms are facing in towards your body. See, Lauren, she's got that full extension. Elbow stays in the exact same spot the entire time here.
Oh, bend the hips.
I call it the robot.
Woo!
All right. Here's where it gets more fun. Oh boy, we're gonna hold the extension and do what I call salt shakers. Hold. Go palms up, palms down.
Oh boy.
Up. Oh, the whole time. Hold the whole time, Lauren. The whole time. Little rotations. You want your dumbbells lifted above your hips back here.
Okay.
All right, 10 more seconds. Woo. These are salt shakers. All right, last movement. Turn those palms in towards your body. You lower down straight arm, and you lift back straight arm. Slow here. Squeeze the triceps back.
Core super tight.
Got it.
Last 15 seconds. Come on, push those triceps beyond what they're used to.
Last 5.
Woo.
4, 3, 2, and 1. Time for your 5 man makers.
Oh,
whoo, I know the
energy.
Arms are feeling it. Take a little shake.
Woo.
Go right into those 5. Try to use the same weight that you did last time.
A little harder when those arms are tired.
Oh. I have a feeling by the end, these aren't gonna look as pretty. Breathe here, that's the key. This is technically your rest break.
Hanging strong. You've got a little over a minute left in this rest.
Breathe. Focus in on that form. When you're done those 5, sip of water.
Whew. What muscles next?
Shoulders. We'll start off overhead just like we did last time. We got 30 more seconds.
I'm trying to think, make 5s.
Whew. Weights are up to you. How are you feeling? You feeling a little shaky.
Feeling that upper body.
Like, whoa.
Shoulders in 10.
Like I said, we will start off overhead. Your palms are gonna face forward. Elbows at 90 degrees. Overhead press. 3, 2, and 1. Straight up. Down to that 90. Go ahead.
As I was gonna say, you can start this form with your feet parallel. Some people, if you start to get tired, a staggered stance might feel a little bit better. Just be careful that you're not starting to really sway that back.
You said parallels?
so fancy. We're taking it to an alternating press, one arm at a time. Right goes up, left goes up. So the one that's not moving is hanging out in your 90 degrees. Still working. Ooh, I am glad I did not pick up the tens. All right. Got one more move. Well, it's lifted nice and high here. Keeping the elbows at shoulder height. Bring both of them at 90. We close in and we open out. Ooh. Yeah. Thighs, I feel it. Keep those elbows shoulder height. Come on, fight for it. We're there with you. We feel it. Woo.
I feel it.
Dropping down, upright row. Elbows go high.
Oh, thank goodness.
It's almost like a relief.
It is. Those weights are staying very close to your body. Elbows right out to the sides. You're still standing super tall.
Oh, coming up on the last minute of work. And all right, 3 minutes never felt so long in your life.
All right, this next one, 90 degrees here, open. So external rotation, shoulders are gonna stay low, and look for that little squeeze in those shoulder blades as you open those weights up, or open those arms up. Very purposeful movement here.
Hi, Jax.
Last one from that is 90 degree, out wide.
Ooh.
Hey, lateral raise.
Yes. 30.
Lateral raise with the bent elbow.
If there is anyone out there whose shoulders are not screaming, for starters, grab heavier weights, but you can also take this with your arms straight. That'll make it harder if you're looking for a way, which you're crazy yourself, but if you're looking for a way to make that harder, that's an option.
10 seconds.
Woo, woo.
Three, two, and one. Time for 5 man makers.
Oh, shake it off.
Yeah, a little shaky. 2 minutes to do them.
Okay, here we go.
Woo. We got a thumbs up. Love it.
Woo. Yeah, actually, that's a good thing. So we're curious how long these man makers are taking you guys out there. When you finish your man maker, go ahead and give us a thumbs up on that screen.
If you can.
If you can. If your fingers can. All the way, Steph, dialed in on that form.
Nice, I see some thumbs up. Nice work, you guys, you're fast. Whew, you see James is in here.
What's up, James?
They didn't take a rest break like in the beginning.
I know. Yes, you guys, hitting those thumbs up. Love it. Oh my gosh, I feel my arms. Whew. So, chest next, right?
Chest is next.
Good news, chest next. Chest is a bigger muscle group, so those arms that just worked so hard are gonna be working right there with you. You're probably gonna wanna go a little heavier if you have that option. If not, trust me, we're going 3 minutes straight, so you're gonna feel it. But if you can go a little heavier, chest can do it. Right. We go in 10.
Down to the floor. Let
me make this.
Yeah. Traditional chest press first. Your palm face towards your toes.
There you go.
Toes, 30 seconds.
That's a good angle.
Oh, get over there.
Right before those elbows hit the floor, press it back up. Don't let any rest come in to that muscle group. 10 seconds. Mm-hmm.
This next one, we're gonna hold our right arm extended, pressing with the left only. Let's go, right into it. Left only does the press.
Strong stabilization in that right arm. Hey, buddy.
We're good.
Abs tight, draw that belly button down towards the spine. 10 seconds to the switch.
Here we go, opposite arm in 3, 2, and 1. Other arm extended, so that press. Elbow hovers on the outside.
Ten seconds to the switch.
Next movement, we're gonna turn our palms facing in towards one another. Narrow press, elbows come down on the sides. Here we go. Narrow press. Palms face in towards one another. Again, elbows stay off the ground.
Woo! Hey, hey! So this is sometimes called a hammer press or a tricep press, so you're probably feeling those triceps after all that work. 10 seconds to the switch.
Flies are coming up next. Woo. That tiny bend in the elbow. And they go out wide in 3, 2, and 1. Fly, fly, fly.
Another one right before those arms touch the floor. Squeeze it back to center. Woo, we're close, guys.
We're gonna go into single arm fly up next, alternating that arm. So only one arm goes out at a time in 3, 2, and 1. One arm stays lifted, other arm goes out and alternate. Last 30 seconds with this one before we get our rest-ercise. Yeah.
Lock that body tight when that weight goes out to the side. Don't let the body shift with it. Everything stays centered. The only thing that moves is that one arm. Final 10 seconds right here.
Woo!
Let's go, let's go. Woo. Oh my gosh, I'm shaking. 3, 2, weights down. Oh my goodness.
Man-maker time. Who's gonna finish it first?
Oh, who's gonna get that thumbs up first? Why'd you have to make it a race? Oh my, that push-up is mean.
It is.
And then you get a little breather. Oh boy, oh boy. Doing great, T. A perfect example of fighting for that perfect form. Yes, love those thumbs up, guys. Way to get those 5 in there. Oh my gosh. Oh. So really, really good news. We are going lower body. I don't know about you, I think upper body needs a little breather. Coming your way, 20 seconds.
It is lower body, it is legs, right? Yeah, it can be legs. So, your legs back.
So we're gonna start off a side lunge. I want you lunging to your left leg. Grab your weights, you step out to the side and frame your knee. Here we go in 3, 2, and 1. Side lunge, chest stays lifted. Power off of that moving leg to bring yourself back up to standing. Keep a proud chest when you come down into that lunge. If you had a logo on your shirt, I should still be able to read it when you're down there.
Oh, you can read my shirt. Inhale, exhale.
Exactly.
All you gotta do. Rest with sides in 3, 2, and 1. Out to the right.
Yep, you should be able to watch us the entire time on these. Sit back into your heel. There. We're going to alternate curtsies up next in 3, 2, and 1. Curtsies back behind. Alternate legs. Chest up. Try to keep your shoulders and your hips squared forward. Back knee bends. Gets close to the floor.
Coming up next.
We're gonna hold our weight up nice and tall, feet wide, sumo squat into it.
Down
and up. The weights are feeling heavy.
You can drop down to one weight
and hold it in the center. Do not let that weight rest on your chest. I want it a little bit away from the body. Okay, ready? We're gonna hold it low in 3, 2, 1. Hold low, one heel at a time, lifts and alternate. So right and left, right and left. Stay low, chest is up. Breathe here, 10 seconds. This is not the hard part. Woo, the hard part's coming. We're gonna stay low. You're gonna lift both heels and you're gonna hold them up in 3, 2, and 1. Hold both heels right here. Breathe.
Embrace the shake.
Yes, this is the shake. You got it. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Chin up, eyes forward. Don't come out of that squat yet.
Can you get a little lower last 10?
10 seconds. That's a challenge.
Come on, come on.
Last 3, 2, and 1. Come out of it. Hey, hey, man maker time.
Whose idea was this?
Man makers. Lauren. Get him done. Get him done. More reps here. We're gonna flip the palms facing backward and go high row, out wide. A similar movement, but palms face back. With this one, elbows go out wide. You can just separate the weights and you bring them back together at the bottom. Yeah, big squeeze in your shoulder blades at the top. We're gonna stand tall, going into an upright row, hitting that one again. 3, 2, and 1. Upright row, elbows high. A little bit of a break from that hinge position. We will go back to it. Oh, yeah. Crown of chest, shoulders back, elbows high. Reverse fly coming up next. We go back into our hinge, palms face in towards one another. Fly out wide. Here we go. Reverse fly. You need a little bit of a modifier. You can go elbows close and go a little bit wide. Right? Couple options here. Lauren, drop down to some lighter weights.
Yeah.
Because these are crazy.
Those aren't going out there for a fly.
And go straight arms like Lauren has. Or I've got a little bit of a bend in my elbow. Now here's the switch. We're gonna go one arm at a time. Same movement, the fly. One hangs out in the center, the other one goes out wide. Right, I'm joining you.
Oh, yeah,
I'm joining you.
Feel that core.
A little bit lighter.
Like always, body locked in. Just that one arm goes out.
Last 30 seconds, we're gonna stand tall. Bring our weights to the collarbones. Good morning. So it's a hinge at the hip. And then the up tall. Feet are planted. Hip width apart.
Think about that lower back here. So it's like a back extension. Bringing you tall. Just moving at the hips. Final 10. Woo. Hey, Lauren, what's next? Man-makers!
Man-makers! 3, 2, and 1.
Oh, here we go.
Man-maker time.
5 man-makers. Give us a thumbs up when you get them done. Let's go.
Who's going to be the first one? That push-up's killing me.
I know. Feeling it.
Off in a plank position. Keep weights close by. Just one. We need just one, I think.
Just one. The
just one. Just one. 20 seconds till we go.
You might want your like a heavier option, and it actually doesn't have to be a dog. I mean, anything. This first one's a plank drag, and something a little heavier will challenge you here. We go in 10.
10 seconds. So this is your reach under, plank drag, plank transfer. I've got lots of names for it. You can go high plank, you can go on the knees, up to you, let's go.
Take your feet a little farther apart than usual to help you keep that strong balance. The hand farthest from the weight reaches under and transfers it over. And per usual, body locked in that tight position. Don't let it shake around. 10 more seconds here.
Our next movement's gonna be a side plank.
I'll want you down on your elbow. You're gonna take that weight with you. Here we go. 3, 2, and 1. Find your side plank. You're gonna roll the weight up. Look forward. Let it tap down to the ground each time. That's okay. Big row. Elbow directly below your shoulder. Less than 10. Before we transfer to the opposite side. In 3, 2, and 1. Let's go other side, right into it. No more planks after this one. Breathing through it. Keep it going, keep it going. That bottom knee can come down to the ground if it needs to. Almost, almost. Come into your back, double crunch in 3, 2, 1. Take your weight overhead, legs are long. You bring your knees into your chest, weight on top here. This one, your lower and your middle back stay on the ground. As you extend out, heels stay off the ground, weight stays off the ground. Notice Lauren's just got her head, neck, shoulder blades lifted here. I like to set my head down every time, every rep, or you can hold it lifted the entire time. Whew. Are you ready to switch? Please. All right, you're coming up to a boat pose. Right leg extended, weight at your chest, rotate to the right side. So over top of that straight leg. One heel is down, one leg's extended. It's like a Russian twist and a boat pose infused together. And only twisting one side. Only twisting one side. Oh, okay, almost 5 seconds. Woo, get ready, switch legs. Switch the twist direction, 3, 2, 1. Let's go, last 30. Whew. Stay in it, stay strong. Final 10. Here we go. Three, two, one. Man makers, good news and bad news. Bad news, man makers. Good news, this is your last set of them. Woo! We didn't tell you that. Last 5. Best 5, let's go.
Best 5.
Woo! I might take these super slow so I feel it all. Okay, crazy. This time. It's a little reprieve there. We got 30 more seconds of this rest-ercise before we go back into biceps.
Oh man.
Woo. Woo. So 90 seconds of work each time. We're gonna pick and choose something that we did last time, maybe something new. Woo. 1 minute rest break in between. No man makers unless you want to, like unless you're crazy. We're gonna start off full range bicep curls, all the way up, all the way down, in 3, 2, and 1, and over here. Right back into it. Whew, that felt like the shortest rest break of them all, right? So now that the rounds are cut in half, don't be afraid to go a little heavier if you have that option. Whew.
hold that left arm halfway down, right arm goes all the way up, all the way down. These were the murderous ones last time.
Still the same.
Still the same. Woo. All the way up, all the way down. 15 more seconds to the side until we switch it. Less than 10. Switch arms in 3, 2, 1. Other arm holds.
Oh boy.
30 seconds of bicep, then you get rest.
Woo.
Close it in, bring it out.
go. In and out. Now this one, make your arms only doing the work, all right? I always see people trying to do like a chest pop dance with this one. No. We're not the Backstreet Boys. Slow it down. Are your elbows still at shoulder height? Have they dropped? Now your weight's right about eye level. Make it a little bit higher or lower. Last switch up, hold them wide. Go down. And then go up. We didn't do this one last time.
New one!
Woo!
It's mean!
It's a scarecrow. You can't do both arms, do one at a time. Oh, that could be like a fun little dance move. Right? Everything we do is dance moves. Shake, 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 10 seconds. Woo! Nice little burn up one last
time. Okay, shoulders.
Two. And one. Woo! Take a rest. We didn't do that one last time because I physically felt I could not. Oh, I had it programmed for halfway through in the 3 minute series and I was like, there's no way we're gonna survive if we do this. Okay. Chest up next.
Go ahead.
We get to be on the
floor.
Lauren, which one do you wanna do on this one? Do you wanna do flies or do you wanna do presses?
Oh.
Or a little bit of both?
Let's do both.
I'll let Lauren take the reins on this one.
Okay.
So we're gonna start with a press. We're gonna do an alternating press, and then we'll end with some flies.
I like it, I like it.
Light or heavy, up to you. Maybe a little bit of both.
Got me an alternating press first.
Yeah. Oh no. We go in five, coming down. Abs tight, weights up over that chest. One at a time, right here in that chest press. Right before the elbow touches the floor, bring it back up towards the ceiling. Lower back, press into the floor. Long spine.
Ooh, my arms are shaking.
Make sure those weights are up over the chest, not over your head. 5 seconds, and we're going into that fly. So both arms up, palms face in towards each other, soft elbows come out to the side. Back in. Moving at the same time. Remember to breathe. In 5 seconds, we're gonna go alternating. So you're gonna keep that same movement, but one arm at a time. I love this exercise because you feel the core so much. So really lock in, don't let the body move as that weight comes out. All the way, finishing it up. Mm-hmm. 10 seconds. Three, two, relax it down. 1 minute of full rest.
Then legs, legs, we stand it up for legs.
Woo, how we doing?
Thumbs up, sweaty face emoji.
Strictly straight.
Feel it up.
Feel it. Both heels lifted in three, two,
One, keep them lifted and hold. This is our finisher last time. We're gonna make it to midway point this time. Just hold. Stay still.
Hard thing to do these days.
Right? Shaking's okay. But no intentional movement other than that. 10 seconds, so we put our heels down and then we're gonna pulse it out for the last 30.
Woo!
All right, just when you think your legs are about to break, go heels down, whole squat, 30 seconds.
Getting that low range of motion. Come on, embrace that bird.
Tiny pulse. Chest up, shoulders back. Breathe. 15 to go.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can. All the way. Three, two, one.
Weight down.
Woo.
Shake it, shake your legs. Whoa. Little dance moves. Breathe. Back's up next. We got back, we have core, and then we're done.
Woo. 3 minutes of work left.
We got this.
Woo.
Start off with our underhand row. I love the underhand row.
Yeah.
It's my favorite. Favorite thing.
Still have 30 seconds. Take any movement, any stretches that feel good to you right now, any dance moves that call to you.
Jackson's so much more behaved on strength days.
Yeah.
He's not jumping around.
Gotta go.
Yeah.
He's bored.
Oh, we made him tired. You know, a mid-morning nap. 10 seconds. We go underhand row up first. Bend the knees, hinge up the hips, palms face forward. Pull to your lower rib cage in three, two, one, let's go. Big row, squeeze the shoulder blades together at the top. Cool. We're going to good mornings up next. You're gonna bring your weights to your collarbones. Stand tall in three, two, and one. Weight to the collarbones. This is the hinge. And then bring it back up tall. Bring it to your collarbones, maybe even your shoulders. I like the shoulders. Mind into that muscle. Think about the lower back lifting you back tall from that hinge. One more rep, you're gonna hold in your hinge. Take your weights back down to your hands, palms in, alternating row, one at a time. Palms face in towards each other. Big pulls, big pulls. Straight up. Keep that tiny bend in the knees. Less than 10. And rest, settle down. 1 minute, nice and easy.
All we have is core.
Core. Core, core, core. It's crazy. Second time around, you're doing these for 90 seconds, and you're like, how did I ever do 3 minutes? How did we get through those long?
How is that possible?
Woo. Breathe, breathe, breathe.
So one weight. Maybe one heavier one.
Huh.
And we're gonna do our double crunch to start with. That's the one where the legs and the arms reach, coming in.
All right.
We go in about 20 seconds.
Lots of time.
Lots of 90 seconds of work.
Woo!
Woo! Finish it strong on Strictly Strength Day.
Nice, flew by. I like it, I like it.
We go in five. So that one dumbbell, one weight, one water bottle, whatever you've got in both hands. Here we go. Crunch it in and extend it out. Back stays in contact with that mat. Head up or down. Five seconds to the switch. We're gonna come up into that half Russian twist.
So come up, extend your right leg long, and you're twisting over towards the right side. So you're twisting over the leg that's up. Fight to keep that leg lifted. That's working the abs too. Dial in. 10 seconds. And switch it up. Final 30 seconds of work right here. Staying strong. Focus on that form. Ending with those perfect reps. So close. 3, 2, relax that weight down. Oh my gosh. Stay where you are since you're on the floor. Bring the soles of your shoes together. Walk yourself a little closer. Stay tall and hinge yourself forward. So right into a couple stretches because per usual, we're cutting it close. I think we've got 3 minutes before Instagram calls us off. So thank you all so much for joining us today. Extend those legs out, reach for those toes.
That was a good one.
So yeah, we hope you had some fun. We wanted to find some ways to get some weights in there. Got a couple of ideas rolling around for classes, but we might be reaching out, so keep an eye out to see. We're curious what equipment you guys have at home, if there's anything else. Otherwise, we'll keep using towels and broomsticks and laundry detergent and having fun with it.
Pots and pans.
Pots and pans.
Wine bottles. Everybody's got wine bottles.
Everyone's got wine,
right? If you don't, go see Josh.
yes.
Wine sale.
To-go program. So there is some yoga coming up today. And then, let's see. Thursdays are a little lighter.
I feel like there's...
Yeah, oh no, because there's yoga this morning. So one more chance for movement this afternoon if you want to stretch it out a little bit. Otherwise, lots on tap for tomorrow. Check the schedule. And you guys know you can find us Saturday, 10 a.m. for our HIIT and core class. Otherwise, thank you so much for joining us. I just saw the warning. It's about to go. Everybody have a really awesome Thursday. Thank